Now this is an interesting slide. And be honest with yourself, right? Yesterday when we and Kisho were discussing about this slide, we had our opinion about this slide itself. And the interesting point we brought about is that we don't realize that we are in that zone. I mean, we ought to be in this zone. Raise your hand if you want to be in this zone. Or you believe you are in this zone. No, you are collaborative in my nature. Raise your hands. All of you are collaborative by nature. And how many people are adversarial by nature? Very easy, only two people. But what about the rest? They have to be either in between, right? The question is, we don't realize it. We behave, the other person perceives us as to be in this zone. And therefore, this slide is to just highlight that if you are operating in this zone, where all you will come across a challenge in the negotiation side. Now with me so far? Huh? Okay, so let's try to identify what are the difference between these two styles of negotiation and how we can still bring out a negotiation. Now, in a collaborative environment, you use personal power. So, what actually can someone do? You heard a book from Robin Sharma, the man who had no title. Read this book? Right? Raise your hands if you have read it. Heard it at least.
Not
okay, not fine. Just heard it. Right. So you don't need a position. You don't need to be a CEO. The ICC asks me, who are you right now in the district? Actually, I'm nobody. I'm just a plain member. That's it. I have no title in those muscles. But then, why you still call a person called Rashkar Mansar to present this? Because it's a personal power. I've been for so many years. I've seen so many clubs in operation. I've seen the challenges. And maybe, from that experience, I can bring to these four people who are speaking. It's a personal power. It comes from you as a person, your knowledge, your experience, your ability to influence people. Make sense? And when you do from here, the ability to negotiate and get things done is far better. In fact, I'll just take a minute to share one interesting thing which you may want to look up in Google later on in the day. There's a guy called Bob Cialdini. Bob Cialdini is a person who is, I think, the only top 10 people in the world who understand how to negotiate. And he calls it as principles of persuasion. And one of the principles I'm going to talk about on this topic is authority. Sometimes you'll feel, many of these sessions, you go for training sessions, the guy will come in a jacket and a tie and all that, right? You have a phone out. Very rare you will find a person presenting with the jeans and shorts and all. Have you seen some presentation like that? Or presenter like that? You have it, right? The reason is, these guys want to establish personal power, authority, that I am an authority here. And therefore, please listen to me. That's the first thing they want to make an impact. And that's where this personal power comes into play. Whereas the position power is where, I'm president, tomorrow you're going to take a speech and that's it. Chapter closed. I'm president boss, come on. That's the position. How many of you feel that you have used this kind of power in the past? And be honest to ourselves. I must appreciate that you are honest to yourself. Boss, nothing is moving. I'm president, you are giving a speech tomorrow. You are taking a role tomorrow. We often use because we become frustrated. This is not working. You don't have elephants in the room as well. You don't have cameras either. Right? So we're using position power to get people. However, what is happening is, this is not long-lasting. Once I will do, twice I will do, third time I will not. You go healthy. Because in those muscles, one thing you realize is it's an informal setup, there's no hierarchy. We all say, my president is a software engineer, I may be in ADP in the company. How does it matter? Does it matter if actually no, he's the president of my company. He's sitting in front of me. It is Rashmar, tomorrow you go to the sergeant and ask, I have to do it. And seriously, it happens because it is actually no hierarchy in Toastmasters. So if you impose a hierarchy in getting things done, you will not. Beyond a point. It does work on one or two occasions. However, in this setup, it works. So when they have to get things done in Infosys, they come to me and say, Rashmar, can you say this? We need a budget for something. Then they'll come to me and say, Rashmar, can you talk to the senior and get some budget for us? I'm using personal power to get them some budget. I didn't get it by the way. That's science. How does physics is something I know? There's a hand. We all know what you're talking about. We all know mutual gain. That's a big thing. I was talking to this lady called Sumitra Manmohan. How many of you know her? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She's actually an elephant. Zero Toastmaster, if I say. She's the first woman TTM of this country. First woman TTM. Everybody will know? You must know, right? And she has been, of course, the president of Bangalore Toastmasters. She has been the mentor of our club. She has been dons. I called her up and I was just trying to chat her up on this subject and said, what is your view on this? How do the newer members negotiate with people? And if you know what she said, the only thing she said is that FM radio, what's it for me? If the members who are going to take projects feel that there is a value in doing what I'm asking, then I will come. So if I have to feel somebody to take a role or a speech, I have a requirement. That guy doesn't fit that. There's no that FM radio which is written as working. The third aspect is about long-term relationship. Now here again I bring Robert Cialdini's one of the principles about lightning. We talk about something called lightning means you have to be liked by the individual to be able to reciprocate in the way you want to get things done. Let me rephrase this. How do I make myself likable? Is it dressing up, the way I speak, common interests, what else? What does liking actually mean to you? How can you be
able
to? You are getting there. Any other liking? Yeah, so I think you are almost there. Like rapport. I think liking is all about experience. I can't express, I like him for whatever reason, I like him. And that liking doesn't happen overnight, happens over a period of time. So what they suggest and what I would recommend further is that you have to build a network within your own club. You want to negotiate and get things done, and one fine day you take a project. Chances are that 99% will say no to you. But if you build a network of your club members in terms of finding out what they like to do, why they're into the club. Some people don't want to become good public speakers, I'm telling you this. They don't want to become good public speakers, they just want to have fun. That's it. And you want to do projects because I'm not interested, boss. So that the question is, what is the individual's requirement, business requirement? And that comes with knowing the members. Raise your hands, honestly, if you know 50% of your members. 50% of members, not by name, but what their interests are. See the hands are wrong. The reason is, yes, I know my name. I know 50% of my members' name. But second level of